and welcome to a new Canon Life tutorial. As we can see, we're not on Canon Life, we're on Inkscape. That's because we're gonna do a tutorial on maps today. I wanted to work with an SVG map because it's better for quality. So I downloaded this SVG and I have all of the countries individually. So we're gonna do a few things. We're gonna make countries appear and we're gonna draw a path. So I decided to make something that was like a path, and as we go in the countries they appear. And I actually changed the color of them all already. You can just like select everything and then you can change the color by going into fill and stroke, and then you can change the color. Okay, so once you have the color you want, you're gonna export your first layer, which is gonna be just word.png. A few things: you have to export the full page every time so you're sure they're all the same size. Then you're gonna make it quite big, so I just changed it to 300 dpi. It depends on how much you want to zoom in the end. The thing is, Canon Live, like a lot of softwares, doesn't handle vectorial thingies, so you're gonna have to export it as a PNG, because in any way Canon Live will make it a PNG, so you want it to be a good quality. So I decided to make it this big. I will do export. I will just replace it because I've done it once already, but yeah. Let's say I want to make a trip from France, that's where I'm from. And then I'll go somewhere like Ethiopia, and then lastly Australia.
I have not been to most of these countries, but I'm sure they're great.
And I will change their color a little bit so that we can see them better when we pass through them, I guess, with the map.
So I will change the brightness and the saturation a tiny bit.
I guess that's good.
And now I'll go back here, I'll make sure to select page. I will change the name to countries. And I will hide all except selected. Then I will only see these countries and not the rest, so export. And replace. And lastly, I will make a path. So to make a path, you go and select the Bezier Curve tool. And you start wherever you want, so in my case I will start in France. I will go through Ethiopia, and I will end somewhere in Australia.
I don't know where, just end here.
And then right click to end the path. And it's a bit weird towards here, so we're gonna do some changes on it. I'll select it here and take my path and make this a bit bigger. Okay, that's pretty cool. The other thing is I don't like its color. And I don't like how it looks either, so that's a lot of things to change. I will go to stroke paint and I will change it to like a blue. Blue is nice, blue is a nice color. Quite light. Yes, that's good. It's a bit too thin, so I'm gonna make it 2 pixels thick. And I want it to be with dotted line, a dotted line? I guess that's what it's called. And I will put markers at the beginning and ends with little circles, and even in the middle in our stop in Ethiopia. And I just realized it's a bit too dark, so I will make it lighter so we can see it better. That's better. And so now I have my stroke. And I will also export this path. I will select it and export the full page again in the same resolution, and I will call it.
I can't select it, and there's the freaking screen key in front of it. I will call it world_path. Of course, you can name it whatever you want, you know.
And export. So then I will go into Canon Live, which is already open in my case, and I will also go here and import all of my PNGs. And I will say no. This is important. You have to say no to this question, because you do not want them to change your resolution. You made it big so you could zoom in. So yeah. I already have added a few tracks. To add a track, just click on any track and do insert track, and you can add as many as you want. So the first thing I'm gonna do is make a background. In our case here, it's quite dark, so if I just leave it on the black, it's gonna be too dark. So I will actually put my world on V2 and add a color clip. I will make it white because it looks good with white. And I will put it here. I will also extend everything while I'm here because the trip is quite long, so you want a bit of time to make it.
No, friends to Australia is like, I don't know, 20 hours? No, yeah.
So first you have your color clip and then you have your world. Everything is nice and we're gonna want to move on this map. It's quite small right now. We want it bigger, so we're gonna zoom in with a composite transition. Why not use a transform? Because it will allow us to move all of the tracks at once. So I go here on composite and I will zoom in quite a bit. I actually click on the line because then there's not the weird black part. And I will zoom in actually 220%. I already know this. You can just change whatever, like choose whatever you like. It also depends on the resolution at which you exported it. I will start by centering my friends, and to make sure it's centered, I will actually add a little overlay here that you can change here. And then I have the center, and so I will put my friends in the center. Well, my friends, everybody's friends, you know, but yeah. Then I will go somewhere in the middle, but not really in the middle, because Ethiopia is closer to France than it is to Australia, at least on this projection. And I will move my map to have Ethiopia in the center. And I will go to the last keyframe and put Australia on the cursor this time. I will just, like, yeah, maybe like this, because there's nothing on the right, so it looks kind of weird. So right now it moves, it will be kind of choppy. It goes like in a really straight line and I don't like it that much. So I will add a few stuff, few things. I will go here and add a keyframe very close to the first one, another close to the first and the here, and another one here, and I will move them towards the middle. And this will make it so that it's a bit smoother in these places. And I will actually move this one as well, because I wanted to stop in Australia for a while. And I will just maybe add another keyframe. So now it's moving a little bit smoother. So now that we have our first thing, the second thing we're gonna add is our countries. So if I just put it here, you'll see that it's not aligned with what we want. That's because we didn't do anything to it, but things are coming. First, we're gonna add a rotoscoping effect to it so that we can show one country at a time. So first, we will show France. So I will just select France and change the alpha operation to minimum. I will remove the keyframe, go back to the first one and make sure that it's on France. It is. So now you have France selected, but you want each country to show up in one frame. So you go somewhere in the middle, you add a keyframe right before you want to add your actual moving keyframe. Then you move one keyframe up, add a keyframe, and here you'll grow the mask so that it takes in Ethiopia. Then you go towards the end and you do the same thing a second time.
And now we select Australia as well. Australia is so big compared to the other two countries, it's crazy.
So it's still too small and the fix is really easy. You're gonna add a transition here. And it could actually be pretty much anything. We're just gonna make it composite because you don't want a wipe. Like, wipe is weird. But most of them would actually work. Maybe like Kero Blend would work, I think. That is weird. I don't want this. We'll just go with composite. Composite works great. I do realize there's an issue here with the rotoscoping. So we're gonna reselect it a bit better. Yes. Make sure it's good for Ethiopia as well, and I think we're good. So now we have a map that moves and shows one country at a time when we arrive in this country. So Ethiopia is a bit late, so I will move these two keyframes a bit up, and actually this is new, you can zoom in on this now. You can zoom in on this little thing here, so I can move them more precisely. Okay, and now we should be good. Then we're gonna add our path. So you just take it and you put it here, and kind of in the same way, you're gonna add a rotoscoping effect. And I'm actually gonna try something. I didn't try this yet. I will just copy this rotoscoping to the other one and see if it works. It might. Okay, it starts a bit too big. We'll just make this smaller. There's only the dot at the beginning. And then you can just remove this keyframe because you don't need it. And maybe this, yeah. And then you go to the last one, you remove the second to last, and you go here. And it doesn't need to be that big. And then you will just copy this composite onto the next track. And make sure it is on V2. Well, it doesn't really matter that much, but it's better. V1 is not good in any case. One thing I realized is I want some smoothing on this, some feathering. So I will add a bit of feathering. Okay, that's pretty cool. We're almost there. I want to add something else, which is the name of the countries. First, let's check that it's nice and stuff. But the good thing with having done it with the composite at the bottom is that we can change it and everything will move at once. And you don't have to copy the transform effect like 2000 times. So we're gonna add the name of the countries, as I said. So first is France. I will actually make it a bit smaller because I know that we're gonna zoom in after, so I will make it at like 40. And well, it doesn't matter where you put it because it's not gonna be in the right place anyway. But so you put it here, make it full even though we won't see it at the end. And actually what I do want to do is add a little typewriter effect on it. So that's pretty cool. You can just click it here and it will do it on its own. So yeah, update title, and it will kind of grow out of France, but you can see that it's not in the right place exactly. But so here you're gonna add a composite and transform transition. Why composite and transform? Because I tried with composite and it looked weird, so you're gonna use composite and transform for this one. You can try with composite, of course, but yeah. And then you're gonna move this composite and transform to put France where it is supposed to be. It's quite hard because it doesn't move the same since we have a zoom, but it's still doable, you know. Now we have France in the right place and it will like show up, and then we move. So that's pretty cool. And then you can just duplicate this clip and name this one, well, not name, change this one to Ethiopia. And put it wherever you like around Ethiopia. Not on it itself, because you won't be able to read since I made it the same color as the countries. So, then you drag Ethiopia. You can make it appear whenever you want. I will make it appear like, yeah, around here, I think. That's good. And I will just copy this composite and transform here. Because it's already there. And I will move my name slightly.
This is so hard.
Okay, I think that's good. If you want to make it easier, actually, what you could do is remove this track. Well, not remove, but not show this track. And now it's easier to see where you're moving. So here we have Ethiopia. And lastly, we will make Australia. So
duplicate clip, Australia, and I will put it roughly in the center. I don't know. It doesn't matter where it is anyway, because it's never like, it's so weird. Well, I mean, it does matter because you could probably calculate it somehow where it ends up when you zoom in, but it's so hard, and I would just rather
make sure you are somewhere where you can actually see it, and I will write Australia like here. And now I can make this appear again, and everything should zoom in and be pretty nice, yes. I do notice that Australia is not really in the right place, so I will move it the tiniest bit here. And that should be okay.
Actually, I don't like where Ethiopia is, so I will change it so that maybe higher than. Yeah, that works better.
I will actually pre-render because it's quite big, this thing, and then we'll see what it looks like. Okay, so it's done. Let's see how it looks. It's pretty cool. I like it. So yeah, that's all pretty much. I hope you liked it. If you did, please give it a like, subscribe, whatever. More stuff coming soon. Bye bye. Handle? Handle?